Hello students, in present video I am going to explain about third problem from journal lesson. This question I am taking from Telangana State Telugu Academy Intermediate First Year Accountancy Test Book. But this video is useful to all commerce students who want to know about journal topic. I made two videos on journal topic, problem 1, problem 2. I am leaving those video links in description box and in icon. I request you to watch those videos first. Then only you can properly understand this third problem. Let us start the problem. First transaction is on 1st March 2019. Transaction is Akbar started business with cash 50,000 rupees. Here Akbar is the owner of the business. He started business by bringing 50,000 rupees cash. While writing journal entries, first step is every financial business transaction contains minimum two accounts. These two accounts we should identify first. Here, cash is coming to the firm now. Therefore, cash account is one account. While writing the journal entry, always we should think from firm's point of view. Let us assume that you are an accountant of the firm. Think from firm's point of view. Cash is coming from Akbar. Therefore, another account is Akbar account. First step is completed. Second step, grouping. Means what? Account is divided into three types. Personal account, real account, nominal account. If any account is opened with a person name or firm name, it is a personal account. If any account is opened with the asset name, it is a real account. If any account is opened with the expenditure name, loss name, income name or gain name, that is a nominal account. Now, cash is an asset. All assets come under real account? No. So, cash account is a real account. Akbar, with a person name we opened this account. It is a personal account. Second step is completed. Now, last step is apply the double entry principles. For real account, double entry principle is debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Observe here, cash is coming. So first line is applicable. Debit what comes in. As per that, we should debit cash account. Second one, personal account. Personal account rule is debit the receiver, credit the giver. Akbar is giving money to the firm. He is a giver. Therefore, second line is applicable, credit the giver. As per that, we should credit Akbar account. In accounts, there is one rule, that is, owner name we should not record in the books. If owner name comes in credit, instead of writing owner name, we should write capital word. So, final entry is cash account debtor to capital account. Narration, being business is commenced. Next transaction is on second date. Cash sales 30,000 rupees. Whenever sales transaction is given, we should identify what they have sold and how they have sold. Firm, generally firm sells goods and rarely firm sells fixed assets like machinery, building, land, etc. Fixed asset name is not available in the transaction. Then we should understand that firm sold goods. Goods are sold. Next one, how they sold these goods. Sometimes firm sells these goods for cash, sometimes on credit basis. If goods are sold on credit basis, compulsory he has to give the customer name. As customer name is not mentioned in the transaction, we should understand that this is cash sale. Therefore, goods are sold for cash. This is a transaction. What happened? From customer, cash is coming and the firm has given goods to customer. From the firm, goods are going. There are two accounts, cash account, goods account. Both are assets. Therefore, both come under real accounts. Real account principle, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. What is coming to the firm? Cash. Therefore, debit cash account. And what is going from the firm? Goods. So, credit goods account. And when goods come in credit, instead of writing goods, we should write transaction name. Transaction is sales transaction now. Therefore, instead of goods, write down sales account. Then final entry is cash account data to sales account. Narration being goods are sold for cash. Next transaction is on fourth day. Cash purchases 40,000 rupees. Whenever purchase transaction is given, we should observe two points. First one, what they have purchased. Generally, firm purchases goods and rarely firm purchases fixed asset. If fixed asset is purchased, that asset name will be clearly mentioned in the transaction. As there is no proper information regarding the asset name, our assumption is goods are purchased. Next, you should observe how they purchase that, for cash or on credit basis. If they purchase on credit basis, then compulsory supplier's name will be given to us. As supplier name is not available in the transaction, we should assume that they purchase these goods for cash. So, to the firm, goods are coming from supplier. And in return, we paid cash to him. Two accounts are goods account and cash account. Both are assets. Therefore, these two accounts are real accounts. Apply real account principle. That is, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Goods are coming. Therefore, debit goods account. Cash is going, credit cash account. When goods come in debit, instead of writing goods word, we should write transaction name. This is purchase transaction. So write down purchases account. Final entry is purchases account data to cash account. Narration being goods are purchased for cash. Sixth day transaction is sold goods to Mahesh 35,000. Sales transaction is given. Whenever sales transaction is given, we should observe two points. What they have sold and how they have sold. Clearly is giving that goods are sold. And customer name is given. Means this is credit sale. So, goods are sold on credit. Firm sold goods to Mahesh. Goods are going from firm. And on this date, Mahesh is not paying cash to us. So, two accounts are Mahesh account and goods account. Mahesh with the person name, if any account is opened, it is a personal account. And goods account is a real account. Now personal account rule. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Mahesh is receiving goods now. He is a receiver. Therefore, we should debit his account. Then goods account. Real account rule. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Goods are going. So we should credit goods account. When goods come in credit, instead of writing this word, we should write transaction name. This is sales transaction. Write down sales. Then final entry is Mahesh account to sales account. Narration: Being goods are sold on credit. Ninth day transaction is bought goods from Radhika 25,000. Again, purchase transaction is given. 2 points we should observe now. First one, what they have purchased. Clearly, he has given goods are purchased. Second, how they have purchased. He is giving supplier's name. Then we should understand that this is credit purchase. Goods are purchased on credit. From Radhika, goods are coming. As this is credit purchase, on this date, we are not paying money to Radhika. Two accounts are goods account, Radhika account. Goods account is a real account. Radhika account is a personal account. Real account rule, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Goods are coming, so debit it. Then personal account rule, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Radhika is giving goods, no, she is a giver. Therefore, we should credit. When goods come in debit, instead of writing goods word, we should write transaction name. This is purchase transaction. So, write down purchases account. Then final entry is purchases account data to Radhika account. Narration: Being goods are purchased on credit. 11th day transaction is sold goods to Swati for cash 10,000 rupees. Sales transaction is given. 2 points we should observe now. First one, what they have sold. Clearly is giving goods are sold. Next, how they sold these goods. If customer name is given, that is credit sale. But in this question, clearly he is giving that it is a cash sale. Then why he has given customer name? To confuse us. Here, don't consider the customer name. So, goods are sold for cash. This is a transaction. Customer name is Swati. To Swati, we sold goods. Goods are going. And immediately, Swati paid cash to us. Two accounts are cash account and goods account. Why we are not considering Swati account? Because from her we received money. So in our books, we need not to maintain her account. We need not to remember her name. Therefore, name is immaterial here. Cash, goods, both are assets. So both come under real accounts. Real account rule, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Cash is coming, debit it. Goods are going, credit goods account. Instead of writing goods, we should write transaction name, sales account. Then final entry is cash account data to sales account. Narration: Being goods are sold for cash. 15th day transaction, Mahesh returned goods 5,000 rupees. Returns are of two types now, purchase returns, sales returns. Observe the transaction, Mahesh returned. Mahesh is returning to the firm. Means once we sold goods to Mahesh, now he is returning these goods. So this is sales return transaction. From Mahesh, goods are coming to the firm. Two accounts are goods account, Mahesh account. Goods is an asset. Therefore, it is a real account. Mahesh is a person name. Therefore, it is a personal account. Apply the rules. For real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Goods are coming, so debit goods account. Personal account rule, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Mahesh is giving goods, no, he is a giver, credit him. Now, goods are coming in debit. Instead of writing goods word, we should write transaction name. This is sales return transaction. So, in debit, we have to write sales returns account. Then final entry is sales returns account data to Mahesh account. Narration: being the entry for sales returns. 18th day transaction is commission received 1000 rupees. This is income transaction. Person name is not given. From whom we are receiving that commission, name is not available now. Take one imaginary name X. From X, we receive a commission. So cash is coming from X. Accounts are cash account is one account, and don't take person name as an account. In case of expenditure and income, we need not to consider the person name. Expenditure name or income name, we should consider. So income name is commission now. Therefore, commission received account is another account. Cash is an asset, so it is a real account. Commission received is an income. Incomes come under which account? Nominal account. Then apply the rules. Real account rule. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Cash is coming. Debit cash account. Nominal account rule. Debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. Commission received is an income? No. Credit it. Then final entry is cash account data to commission received account. Narration being commission is received. 19th day transaction is office expenses paid 500. This is expenditure related transaction. Firm paid cash to somebody towards office expenses. Person name is not available. Take one imaginary name Y. From the firm cash is going. Two accounts are cash account and expenditure name account. Expenditure name is office expenses. With that name, open one account. So don't consider person name here. Because in case of expenditure, to whom we are paying that amount, person name is immaterial. We need expenditure name and cash. With the expenditure name, when we open any account, that account comes under a nominal account. Office expenditure account is a nominal account. And cash is an asset, no? It is a real account. Nominal account double entry principle is debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. Office expenditure is an expenditure to us, debit it. Real account rule, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Cash is going, credit cash account. Final entry is office expenditure account data to cash account. Narration being office expenses paid. 20th day transaction, cash paid to Pramod 6000 rupees. Why firm is paying cash to Pramod? Previously, firm purchased goods from Pramod on credit. Firm is liable to Pramod. On 20th day, firm is settling his account. Firm paid cash to Pramod. This is a transaction. Two accounts are Pramod account and cash account. With the person name, we opened this account. So it is a personal account. And cash is an asset, no? This is a real account. Personal account rule. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Pramod is a receiver. Debit him. And cash, real account rule. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Cash is going from the firm, no? Credit cash account. Final entry is Pramod account data to cash account. Narration being cash is paid to Pramod. 22nd day transaction is returned goods to Radhika 2000 rupees. Again return transaction is given. Returns are of two types now. Purchase returns, sales returns. Observe the transaction. Returned goods to Radhika. It gives the meaning that firm is returning goods to Radhika. Means once firm purchased goods from Radhika, Now firm is returning those goods. So this is purchase return transaction. Two accounts are Radhika account and goods account. Radhika, person name, no, it is a personal account. Goods, asset, no, it is a real account. Personal account role, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Radhika is receiving goods, she is a receiver, debit her. Then goods account, real account role, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Goods are going, credit goods account. When goods come in credit, instead of writing goods word, write down the transaction name. This is purchase return transaction. Final entry is Radhika account data to purchase returns account. Narration being the entry for purchase returns. 25th day transaction is goods withdrawn for domestic use 5000 rupees. Domestic use means for a household purpose, for personal use. Who can withdraw the goods or money for personal use? Only the owner. Owner's name is Akbar. From the firm, Akbar is taking goods for his personal use. Two accounts are Akbar account and goods account. With the person name, we open this account. This is a personal account. Goods account, asset, no, so real account. Personal account role, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Akbar is receiving goods, he is a receiver, debit his account. Real account role, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Goods are going, credit it. When owner name comes in debit, instead of owner name, we should write drawings word. Goods are credited. Instead of goods, what to write? When we purchase goods, we write this entry. Purchases account data to, if it is for cash, we write cash word. If it is on credit, then we write supplier's name. Assume this is cash purchases. When goods are purchased, we are debiting purchases account. From these purchased goods only, owner is withdrawing some goods for personal use. Then this purchase account balance decreases. When purchase balance increases, we are debiting purchases account. When we want to decrease purchase balance, then we should write the purchase account in opposite side. We should credit purchases account. Then final entry is drawings account data to purchases account. So instead of goods, which account is to be credited? Purchases account. Narration is being goods are withdrawn for domestic use. 27th day transaction is cash received from Anand 3800 and discount allowed 200. This is settlement transaction. Anand account is settled with discount. Cash received from Anand 3800 in full settlement of 4000. It gives the meaning that previously we sold goods to Anand for 4000 rupees. Anand is liable for 4000. Anand is a debtor for 4000. As he is paying his due amount on time or before the due date, firm is allowing some discount to him. Instead of paying 4000 rupees, Anand paid only 3800 in full settlement of his account. Here 200 is the discount allowed by the firm to Anand. Three accounts are, cash is coming, cash account is one account. Discount allowed is one account. From Anand cash is coming, now Anand account is one account. Now cash is an asset, so it is a real account. Discount allowed, to the firm this discount allowed is a loss, because instead of receiving 4000 rupees, we are taking only 3800 from Anand. We are losing 200 rupees now.
losses come under nominal account. Then Anand is giving cash. So Anand account is one account and it is a personal account. Now apply the rules. For real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Cash is coming, so debit cash account. Nominal account rule, debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. Discount allowed is a loss to firm, therefore debit it. Anand account, personal account rule, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Anand is giving cash to us, he is a giver, therefore credit his account. Final entry is cash account debtor, discount allowed account debtor to Anand account. Entry contains more than two accounts now. This entry is known as compound entry. As in debit side, we have two accounts. First debit column amounts we should write. And this total you have to write in credit column. Narration is being cash received and discount allowed. 28th day transaction, interest received 500 rupees. This is income transaction now. Person name is not given. Take one imaginary name. From X, we received interest. Means cash is coming from X. Two accounts are cash account and income name. That is interest received account. Even the person name is given, we should not consider person name now. In case of expenditure and income, cash is an asset, it is a real account. Interest received account, income. Income comes under nominal account, it is a nominal account. Real account rule, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Cash is coming, debit it. Nominal account rule, debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. This is income. Therefore, we should credit. Final entry is cash account debtor to interest received account. Narration, being interest is received. 29th day transaction is cash paid to Raman 4900, discount allowed by him 100. This is also settlement related transaction. We paid cash to Raman because once we are liable to him, we purchased goods from him on credit. Amount is 5000 rupees. We have to pay 5000 rupees to him. As we are paying on time or before the due date, Raman allowed discount to us. Amount is 100 rupees. Here, Raman is allowing discount. Means firm is receiving discount. Actually, he should give discount received 100 rupees. Transaction is cash paid to Raman 4900 and discount received 100. Instead of giving like this, from Raman's point of view, he is giving discount transaction. Discount allowed by him 100. Always you remember, while writing journal entries, we should think from firm's point of view, not from customer's point of view or supplier's point of view. Raman allowed discount means from Raman's point of view, he is giving this transaction. But you are not an accountant of Raman, you are an accountant of firm. So think from firm's point of view. When Raman is allowing discount, firm is receiving that discount. So, even though discount allowed word is given, we should open an account with a discount received word, not allowed word. Okay? Right. Three accounts are, we are paying money to Raman now. Raman account is one account. Cash is going. So, cash account is one account. Discount received account is one account. Raman account is a personal account. Cash account is a real account because an asset. And discount received account is a nominal account because this is profit. Then apply the rules. Personal account rule, debit the receiver, credit the giver.
Raman is receiving cash. He is a receiver. Debit him. Real account rule. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Cash is going, so credit cash account. Nominal account rule. Debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. Discount received is gain to us. Therefore, credit it. Two credits, one debit we have. Then final entry is Raman account debtor, two cash account, two discount received account. As credit side, we have two accounts. First credit column amounts you should write. We paid 4900 rupees cash and we received 100 rupees discount. In debit column, write down the total of these two amounts. Narration is being cash paid and discount received. Last transaction is on 31st date. Commission paid 300 rupees. This is expenditure related transaction. Firm paid commission to somebody. Name is not given. Take one imaginary name X. From the firm cash is going. As this is expenditure related transaction, with the expenditure name we should open one account. So commission account is one account. Next one, cash is going from the firm now. Cash account is another account. With the expenditure name, when we open any account, it comes under nominal account. Commission account is a nominal account. Then cash account. Except no, it is a real account. Nominal account rule, debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. This is expenditure to the firm, so debit it. Real account rule, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Cash is going, credit cash account. Then final entry is commission account debtor to cash account. Narration being commission is paid. With this, third problem is completed. Hope this video is useful to you. Thank you.